Yes, as I thought. This is the real Sahelanthropus. You and your friend will die here. Behold, today is the day weapons learn to walk upright!
Oh, shit!
Get out of there, boss. Emery's extraction comes first. Head for the LZ.
Mä en päässyt siihen kyytiin enää, joten... Voi saatana! Aaaaap! Vittu, se on... Metal Gear jo tässä vaiheessa, vittu peli. Voi saatan.
If you don't get away from that thing, it'll bring down the chopper. I'll try to slip somehow. Stay behind cover as you move.
No, näköjään hävitin sen jo.
This is Pequot. Have arrived at LZ. We'll stand by.
Mä luulin, että mä olisin voinut käyttää sitä ihme laitetta, mutta... No, olipa vittu epikkiä taas. Vittu, se ei oo edes perässä enää. Se on vittu edes lähelläkään. No, tuuks sä alas, se ei oo vittu lähelläkään. Oh shit, nyt se liikkuu vittu kova. Vähän liiankin kova.
Stay alert. You're not out of the woods yet.
Ei se tiedä missä mä oon. No vaan on jo piilossa. Mitä vittuu se lähetti? Mitä vittuja noja? Fuck! Holy fuck, se on iso. Fucking hell. Älä please tuu tästä läpi. Ei, ei saa, ei, ei. Ei se saatana voinut nähdä.
All right, the chopper's touching down. Don't waste any time getting on board. And don't forget Emmerich.
Fuck.
Nice work. Getting out of here. Here it comes. Use the chopper's minigun. Shake them off.
The vittu se on tossa jo. Voisitko sä mennä sen vittu kopterin kanssa?
light bipedal weapon. In terms of hominids, it's a sahelanthropus. How did they complete it without me?
We'll hear the rest back at base.
Suspect me. What did I do? I'm on your side. What about him?
Miller was in contact with Cypher 9 years ago. He was working with them. He's the traitor, Snake! What's that? More truth serum?
No. Stronger, truth.
Oh, please. Please keep me here. I need protection. Why?
You're the odd one out.
Why me?
We all lost something.
What?
Truth serum isn't working. Either some procedure he had done boosted his metabolic enzymes, or he's undergone special gene therapy.
What's he saying?
Same as 6 hours ago. I had no idea the nuclear inspection 9 years ago was a ruse. Cypher forced me to do that research after the attack.
Do you think he had a hand in it?
I do. But there's no proof yet. Take a listen to this later.
We need proof before we can pass judgment. Keep an eye on him. And don't tell anyone he's here.
We'll have him continue his research in there. It's for his own good. The older guys will want his head. We can't guarantee his safety if we let him out.
Boss.
He mentioned something interesting. The reason why they pulled their plug on the operation in Afghanistan. He said their funding started going to Central Africa instead. Cypher is pursuing new research in Africa.
Africa? What research?
Emmerich doesn't know the details, but one thing he said does make sense. The Sahelanthropus alone isn't enough to cause an RMA. He claims that what they're doing in Africa is the missing piece. A weapon to surpass Metal Gear.
Meaning it's not just another nuke.
Boss. Cypher's working on something in Central Africa. There's evidence they've been in contact with private forces operating in the region. We follow that evidence. We should learn what Cypher is after. Diamond Dogs has gotten a lot bigger. Now's the time to take the offensive. Head back to the ACC for your next mission.
It wasn't just Cypher. Back in the Caribbean, every eye in the world was turned on us. A private army, just a bunch of guys with guns, in possession of a nuke? Why wouldn't they be uncomfortable?
And that's why you made sure the inspection happened.
Well, I thought our best move was to prove to the UN, through the IAEA, that we had no nuke. Of course, I was against us having it in the first place, but that was Snake's decision.
The boss wasn't responsible.
Well, don't get me wrong, I still believed in Snake. I thought I was making the best decision for all of us, that's all. I figured we should get a third party to exonerate us before proof of the nuke did get out. And who better to do that than an organization with international authority?
So the truth is, you took it upon yourself to agree to an inspection arranged by the UN. Only the inspection was a ruse, and Cypher Strike Force XOF showed up instead.
I had no idea that would happen.
Enough bullshit!
Oh, sure, like I could have known. You know, I was just trying to prove our innocence to the world. What's wrong with that?
We're not interested in the excuses you thought up. The truth is objective.
Just see it from my point of view.
You led XOF to the control tower. They seized it, giving them complete control over the base. Moments later, they detonated C4 on the strut legs. Anyone who'd managed to survive was hunted down by the assault force and their choppers.
You can't believe I did that on purpose!
That was the end of Mother Base. But it wasn't the end for you.
How can you... Look, think about it. I lost something too. I built Zeke and it got buried underwater. I am a victim.
That raises the big questions. Why were you the only one spared? You got away without a scratch. Why did Strangelove leave the base on the eve of the inspection? You two were close.
Strangelove?
And how did you manage to build something that surpasses Zeke in every way? Because you did everything they told you. You're the only one who didn't lose a thing. That is the truth.
I was taken away against my will. Skullface forced me to do his research these past 9 years. He used me. I lost 9 years.
9 years? We all lost 9 years. It wasn't just you.
I suppose blaming me makes you feel better, does it? But who's gonna give me back all the time I lost?
You're not getting anything back. You're not a victim here, Emmerich. You're the perpetrator.
I didn't know anything.
Nobody can back that up.
Yeah, all the evidence is at the bottom of the ocean.
You know the hardest man to break. The type who's fooling himself. That takes time. It's easier to live a convenient lie than a painful truth. Is that the peace you've chosen, Doc?
I'm not lying.
Of course. Just let me check one or two things. On that day, you were in the control tower with him. Lucky you. That's how you got out unscathed. And you escaped on one of their choppers. Only you, right before the base went under.
They had me blindfolded the whole time. I've never been so scared. The whole flight, I thought they'd kill me. But thinking of you kept me going. My comrades, all the way.
And?
There was a plane journey, and then we traveled by road. When they finally took off the blindfold, I was in kind of a warehouse, on the floor. Afghanistan, it was that research lab. I couldn't believe they'd taken me halfway around the world. And soon enough, he came.
Skullface.
He's the one who's really behind that Mother Base attack. He forced me into that research.
What kind of research?
He told me to build a bipedal walking tank for the Soviet Union. Like Peace Walker. A system that could fire an ICBM-class nuclear weapon. That's how the Sahelanthropus project got started.
Sahelanthropus.
Those AI weapons I'd made in Costa Rica were like toys by comparison. A whole world apart from reptilian four-legged crawling and that ridiculous hunched-over bipedal waddling. My design evolved to the dawn of mankind. Sahelanthropus, the first steps towards humanity. An upright bipedal weapon system. Originally, Sahelanthropus was going to be a manned weapons platform. I designed a cockpit in its head, and I planned to fill it with water as a buffering agent.
Like how Paz modified Zeke for human control.
Don't compare me to some amateur. I designed it for human control from the beginning. The problem was miniaturizing the posture control AI. You remember the reptile pod?
The AI that controlled your unmanned weapons.
Attaching it externally makes it vulnerable, so this time I wanted it beneath the armor. Meaning I had to make the AI smaller. I got it down to less than a tenth the size without any loss in computation speed. But it was still too big for the cockpit. There wasn't enough room for the pilot. If I made the head bigger, its body would have to be bigger to support it. Too big to be practical. In the end, human piloting was taken off the table. I tested a remote control system too, but there was the time lag and I wasn't satisfied with its precision either. Plus, it would be useless if the enemy jammed it. So next, I went back to trying an AI-only system. To do that, I had the AI pods recovered from Nicaragua. This was a hybrid AI, a combination of Peace Walker's reptile and mammal pods. The only AIs that had ever successfully operated an unmanned nuclear weapon system.
Really? You'd need some help to get that working. Expert help.
Did you work with someone?
I worked alone.
You did that yourself?
That's the thing. The AI didn't pan out in the end either. But I did finally get Sahelanthropus walking by folding over its upper body to lower its center of gravity. The first upright bipedal locomotive weapon system in the history of mankind. I guess, technically it falls into the anthropoid ape category.
I don't see the benefit of having it stand taller.
On terrain with significant differences in elevation like Afghanistan, you need a body that's vertically adaptable. That also lets it attack from long range while using mountain ridges for cover. So, making it walk upright was the most important factor in giving it superior height capability. As the name suggests, that was the whole point of Sahelanthropus. But I was being pushed for results. Having the AI mounted externally would have been the fastest way to get it working. I just needed more data so it could maintain its balance. But Skullface refused to wait. He dismissed the idea of AI control and took Sahelanthropus away from me before I could finish it.
But it was walking when it came after you.
That's just it. I don't understand how Skullface got it to move upright. Without a pilot or an AI. And walking at that speed, too. It's beyond anything I could have imagined. This is like the Wright brothers making it to the moon. I'm just as clueless as you are.
So this Sahelanthropus, where is it now?
I have no idea. All my experiments took place at that cave. I've never seen it anywhere else. Besides, it's still just an incomplete prototype at this point, and nothing but a paper tiger. Even if it can walk, it's far from being a viable weapons platform. It wouldn't be useful in actual battle.
Emmerich will remain here at Mother Base for now, but not as a member of Diamond Dogs. I still don't trust him. That work for you?
Fine by me. He can't be allowed any contact with staff either.
Yeah. A lot of the guys would love some payback for 9 years ago. We still need him alive. But we have to restrict his movements. He can only go where we tell him. And of course, the interrogations will continue. He worked for that skull bastard for nearly a decade. He still has more to tell us.
How long are we gonna press him?
If our investigation shows he really had nothing to do with the attack, we'll reconsider his place here. But I don't expect that to happen. Remember that water tank-shaped object in Emmerich's lab in the Soviet base camp?
The thing that started talking to you like a possessed answering machine. That was a pod belt for housing the AI used to control unmanned weapons. You remember, back in 74 in Costa Rica. It was in those machines you fought there. They were designated Pupa, Chrysalis, Cocoon, and Basilisk. And each of them was fitted with an AI unit called a Reptile Pod. Emmerich created it. It mainly handled the machine's posture control and autonomous behavior. But the Basilisk, aka Peacewalker, also featured a second AI pod. That one was called the Mammal Pod, and it was created by Dr. Strangelove. She tried to recreate the boss's personality through the Mammal Pod, but you pulled out its memory boards. That's when it transferred its own functions to its reptile pod. Just like a human brain compensating for damage by using the remaining healthy parts. The result was a unique entity. A hybrid of the reptile and the mammal. It sank to the bottom of Lake Nicaragua with Peacewalker. But apparently they salvaged it and transported it to that lab. Don't let it deceive you, Snake. It may sound like the boss, but it has neither a personality nor a will. Like Emmerich says, it's just a machine.
Ever since the attack on your unit 9 years ago, the name Big Boss has become known the world over.
What do you mean?
Those of your men who survived traveled far and wide. They fought throughout the world. In fact, they're part of the reason we have all these PFs now. Every one of them suffered their own phantom pain from losing you. Talking about you wherever they went helped to heal their wounds. Your actions and words, your legend, has been told on every battlefield they've set foot on. Obviously, as the tales have spread, the truth's been distorted, painted over. Big Boss sacrificed himself to show us the threat that Cypher poses. He sounded a warning, so it goes.
A warning?
Too much power destroys the hands that hold it. Apparently, you chose to be a living example of that.
I never said any of that.
The moment any truth is passed on, it starts turning into fiction. The problem is, fiction inspires people more than facts. To the world, you're now the legendary mercenary Big Boss. The lessons you've taught the PFs are the reason they're so widespread. They're the reason they've survived. And you know what they all aspire to? To one day go nuclear, just like you did, and stand up to Cypher.
Of all the stupid things you could do,
they'll never understand what you really wanted. Heroes are misunderstood. It takes a man of the same caliber to understand what drives them. Bottom line is, these guys want to be like their hero, Big Boss. And deep down, they all have their eyes on nuclear weapons. They say that a nuke is the only means of standing against Cypher. But these days, it's becoming little more than a slogan to rally the troops and survive in a cutthroat business.
Currently, there are three major PFs who've expanded into Central Africa. CFA, Rogue Coyote, and Zero Risk Security. HEC's investigations have shown there's almost no overlap between their areas of operation. It's not so much a turf war, more like they have a gentleman's agreement. If you do cross paths with them, you probably won't have to face more than one at a time. Still, don't expect a walk in the park. The CFA, Contract Forces of Africa. These guys are a major player. Their head office is in Pretoria, South Africa. That's also where the South African Defense Force is headquartered. We think the two are closely connected. An HEC investigation revealed that most of the CFA's operators are former SADF soldiers. South Africa has been locked in struggles with neighboring regimes for years. That means constant action. And we know better than anyone that's the best kind of training. A company drawing its recruits from hardened military vets. You can bet they know how to handle themselves. Do not underestimate them. Within the CFA is a company of soldiers made up mainly of locally hired operators. They speak Afrikaans to communicate with personnel from the CFA. But if you notice any speaking the local language, that's them. Though hired from the local population, they were originally part of a paramilitary group, so they'll have plenty of combat experience. And unlike their days shooting junkyard rifles out of beat-up pickup trucks, the CFA now supplies them with the latest gear from the West. On top of that, they've been combat trained by the South African Army. All that adds up to a much stronger fighting force. So don't brush them off.
Look at the Angola-Zaire border region. The east bank of the Muneni River, in particular. It's a microcosm of a problem that stretches all across Africa. There's a civil war going on in Angola, fought between the government MPLA and the Western-backed UNITA. Zaire is still a dictatorship under President Mobutu, but numerous uprisings have broken out in its remote regions. With all the trouble elsewhere keeping their hands full, neither government has control over their side of the border. They depend on militias and PFs, as do the rebels. Government forces, guerrillas, militants, groups of all shapes and sizes hawk whatever resources they can to hire PFs. Conflict brings PFs. PFs expand the war zone, and more conflicts erupt in a continuous chain reaction. Sounds like our kind of work. Mother Base could grow by leaps and bounds.
Mission is...
Boss, I've been meaning to tell you something. Our old friend Zero hasn't been seen in public since you left the States. That was over 10 years ago now. You suspected he was responsible for the accident at your base in the Caribbean. But at that point, Zero was already bedridden. So it never felt right to me that Zero gave the order. Now that I've seen the man Emmerich was working for, I'm sure he didn't. I know that man. He was our old friend's XO. A man without a face. Not one you want to look at, anyway. Skullface. He's the one who destroyed your base 9 years ago. The unit he commands, XOF, was Cypher's strike force. But he's since split from Zero and used XOF to usurp control over Cypher itself. In other words, the Cypher we're hunting isn't Zero. Beyond Zero is a void that's even darker. Skullface.
Okei, viimeksi, kun mä pelasin tätä, mä unlockasin sen Afrikan. Teille se on ehkä muutama minuutti. Joten me mennään seuraavaksi sinne. Ja jos ihmettelette, miksi mun ääni on tällainen ja miksi mä näytän uniselt, mä just heräsin. Joo, yksi juttu, minkä mä huomasin, mikä on niinku aika hienosti tätä selitetty tässä pelissä. Tai selitettiin ja selitetty, siis se näytetään. Se näkee tässä. Peleissä, just tällaisissa peleissä yleensä, niin sä et... Se sun pelin hahmo ei ikinä syö mitään. Tai juo mitään. Tai tee yhtään, niinku mitään sillaista. Mutta tässä pelissä se on jopa selitetty, minkä takia se ei oo. Ja se on toi hemmetin letku, mikä menee tosta käsi... Tää mikä ihme mekanika vai mikä vittu onkaan, niin... Pitkin tonne. Ja on toi kirkas pussi. Toi on varmaan... Kun sairaaloissahan käytetään just sillaista... Jotain nestettä. Mä en tiedä, mitä niissä nesteissä on. Mutta sä pystyt olemaan syömättä ja juomatta ihan helposti niinku... Monia päiviä. Musta tuntuu, että toi Snake pörrää no jollain litkuilla pelkästään. Daily bonus received. Yes. Mun ääni on hieno. Siis, niinku, mä tykkään tästä aamuäänestä. Nää on loistavia nää aamuäänet. Mut joo, Staffi. Oliks täällä mitään ihmeellistä? Ai niin, mun piti ne troublemakerit kattoo täältä vittuu taas. Troublemaker violence.
Select unit.
Fuck. You!
Staff dismissed.
Mä yksi päivä myös mietin sitä, että kun mä potkin porukkaa pihalla, niin mullahan tulee noin kaikki noin levelit, noiden tiettyjen osien levelit tulee alaspäin. Sitten mä mietin silleen, että kumman sä haluu. haluut, että haluatko sä pienemmän levelin sille sun jutulle, mutta paljon paremman joukon sinne niihin leveleihin, vai haluatko sä helvetin isolevellisen systeemin, tai noin isolevelliset noin alueet, eli noin R&Dt ja mitä noit on. Mut sitten se on ihan täynnä kaiken maailman troublemakereita ja kaikkea, että se on täys kaaos siellä jatkuvasti. Mä mieluummin otan ei-kaaosta. Eliminoin kaikki ongelmat mahdollisimman nopeasti.
Select unit. Staff dismissed.
Nyt tuli base development unit leveli tuli alemmas.
Select unit. Staff dismissed.
Joku teistä on ihan helvetin hyviä, hyvää porukkaa, että niinku...
Finda oil field, upstream from the landing point. A spill has covered the whole area and crude. A pipeline that crosses the Muneni River failed, and now the shore's a mess. Not to mention the villages downstream have no drinking water. The oil runs to the pipeline from that facility. Taking it out should end the leak. The client this time is an environmental NGO. Destroy the facility. Stop that leak. This may seem like straight-up philanthropy, but there's another reason we agreed to it. The Mfinda oil field was outdated. Abandoned. Then the rebel group UNITA moved in, taking it upon themselves to kickstart operations. UNITA's been rapidly modernizing its arsenal. Rumor has it someone's been selling them U.S. military hardware. Intel's analysis suggests the broker's a front company, Cyphers. Keeping tabs on United could tell us who's pulling its strings.
Ei tyvi... Uusi alue. Ja vielä viidakko. Tästä tulee siis niin Snake Eateri mieleen. Me ollaan... ihan... tän kartan... vasemmassa tää... Joo, tota... Mulla on nyt toi sniperi, toi uusi sniperi, minkä mä hankin. Joka on ihan helvetin hieno, että se on ton värisenä. Ja tää pikkuhiljaa rupee nää kamat löytyy. Mut joo, tää viidakko tulee varmaan tuomaan omia vaikeuksia.
The war industry we started has taken a pretty crooked course these past 9 years. With no other options, soldiers have become dogs of war, sent to conflict zones as private forces, or PFs. Guys we fought alongside are dying all around the globe for no reason, no banner. But it's how they survive. The demand for PFs here in Africa is especially high. Cold War standoffs, resource exploitation, tribal clashes. What's big business for developed countries has only brought conflict here. That mess you're standing in is just the latest example.
Mistä vitusta tää pääsee?
The map has been updated.
Tästä. Joo, näköjään täällä Afrikassa, niin Täällä on ei ole niin selviä reittejä näin.
Enemy presence detected. The map has been updated.
Täällä on uusia kukkasia. Täällä on varmaan...
It's digitalis. It's toxic, but it can also be used as medicine.
Ja täällä on varmaan osa noista... Holy fuck. Osa noista... kasveista, mitä pystyy kerran. Mitä ei ole Afganistan.
Meaning it'll be stocked with weapons and resources. Should be a thing or two that'll come in handy. Don't be shy. They deserve to be in better hands.
You have signed out.
The map has been updated.
No, venakkaa hetki. Okei, mulla hävisi toi nettijuttu aivan täysin tosta. En tiedä menikö monta netti, mutta mä en ainakaan pysty käyttämään tuota nettiä. Harmi kun se tuo sen noin suoraan naamalle. Ei tossa oo ku toi kaveri on ainoa hyvä. Mä olisin halunnut snaipata, no kaikki no. Tuolla ei näy aina kuolla joku. Ei vittu, ei toi ole kukaan. Toi on joku saatana bussi. Linnun peläti. Eiks tuo oikeesti ole enempää kuin kolme? Tietenkin tuo pidemmällä voi olla, mutta... Tuolla on posteri. Tuolla on toinen posteri. Lisää postereita. Mitä se tuolla skannailla? Tuolla on tyyppi jossain. Tos kohtaa, jos sä oli tyyppi. Hyvä, sekin liikkuu. Oh fuck, se on tulossa tänne päin. Mä haluun tuo tornissa olevan, niin nukuttaa. Tällä kaveri mä en tee yhtään mitään. Voi vittu. Se meni vituiksi. Ja niitä todellakin on enemmän. Okei, nää pitää aikamoista meteli.
Thank you.
Harmillisesti mä en nyt saanut tätä kaveria, mutta... ei sillä mitään väliä. Voi vittu, siis täällä on ihan...
Child soldiers. Children there are abducted and trained to be soldiers. They're only taught to fight. And one day they grow up and teach the next generation the same way. With a gun in his hands, a kid is as dangerous as any adult. Only they don't know a thing about right and wrong. Boss, do not hurt any child soldiers. If you do, the mission is over.
Kovin vähän moni on ampunut menemään suoraan tuosta. Sillä ei oo uhka kuin uhka ja sit vaan PAM! Aaa, mission over. No vittu. Vähäks perseest? Tai no ei sinänsä edes perseest, toi on muuten aika jännä. Jännä konsepti siinä mielessä, että tota... miks tuo vielä tyyppi? Tuollakin on vielä tyyppi, minkä mä ladoin kumaan. Mun auto! Mitä mun auto tuolla tekee? Siinä mielessä aika erikoinen, että kun niitä ei saa tappaa, niin sun on pakko käyttää non-lethal asetta, eli stunnia tai nukutusta. Nukutussa tietenkin se, niin kun, jos miettii, niin nukutushan sehän ei satu. Satua periaatteessa ollenkaan. Tietenkin jos ampuu sillä sen piikkinuoli paskan suhun, niin kyllähän se nyt vähän kirpasee, mutta eihän se nyt paljon. Ja sitä tuli tällainen. Mut joo, se sit tois tunnin asia, sehän sattuu ihan saatanasti, jos se osuu. Jos ootte nähnyt jotain videoita, kun ammutaan sellaisia kumiluoden, niin nehän on ihan vitullisia mustelmia ja kropan sisäistä verenvuotoa, mitä siitä iskee. Kyllähän noilla kumiluodellakin pystyy IRL tappaa ihmisiä. Et eihän ne täysin non-lethal välttämättä ole, mutta... oliks... ei, tässäkin oli vielä tyyppi. Oh fuck, ne on tulossa tänne. No vittu, tulossa tänne päin. Ja vittu, ne menee tolle. That's African peach. The shape of its petals gives it the nickname the pincushion. It's used in local traditional medicine as a pain reliever and tranquilizer. Ne menee nukkumaan. Ja helvetin hieno. Okei, mu... mutta miks mä edes yritän tästä läpi? Mun auto on tuolla.
Analysis complete.
Se ton kaveri mä haluan. Silleen, että minkä takia mä edes yritän tosta läpi. Mä joudun hirveen... ja sit mä joudun kävellä. Joo, ei vittu, kiitos. Mä otan auto ja lähden menemään tonne suuntaan. Heippa.
He's coming too. Roger that.
Extraction
Tää tulee olla niin mielenkiintoinen meistä pelata, varsinkin Afganistanin jälkeen, kun Afganistan on vähän... Se mappi on hyvin sellainen... Siinä ei hirveesti mitään nähtävää, kun se on sellaista hiekkamössöä.
Analysis complete. The map has been updated.
Eiks näet oikeesti?
Analysis on tuolla complete. Analysis complete. Analysis complete.
Okei, siellä on yksi B, mutta... C, mä en tee sillä vittuu. Kato, toi B on kyllä vähän mielenkiintoinen. Okei, siellä on kaksi B. Se on 2B. Sitten plus sitten tossa on auto, minkä mä haluan itselleni. Tässä nukutussnaippari olisi niin loista. Kaikki huomasi.
Guard post captured. The map has been updated.
Joten. Näet mulla on jo ihan tarpeeksi noita. En edes tiedä mitä noin tehdään, niin pystyy ottaa, mutta... Mitä haju, mitä... Kun en mä oon nähnyt niitä enää uudelleen. Jokin Materbassillähän ne menee, mutta mitä vittu ne sieltäkin? Vai saanko mä vaan sitä myöhemmin ne... Sillä et... Kerää vittu 300 noita kappaleet noita, niin saat sitten... Mortari. Ei se silleen... Siinä on jokin muu. Tai siis ne menee vaan rahaks tai jotain. Mä oon kyllä huomannut, että ne olisi mennyt rahaksi, mutta... Se on näköjään, kun tollaan sniperi vetää. Niin noin huomaa aika kaukaa. No sinänsä ei edes saa aika kaukaa. Se yksi oli tässä, mä ammuin yhden tuolta. No on tää. Siis toki on tuolla oli. Toi yksi kaveri. Eikä ne huomannut sitä. Sehän vähän ei nyt meikkaa senssiä yhtään. Tossa muuten toi CAF-logo tossa kyljessä. Muuttuuko se, jos mä menen tohon kyljään? Ei. Se ei muutu ollenkaan. Heippa. Se olisi niin loistava jos toi. Just like weapons and items, you can use your iDroid to have vehicles you've extracted airdropped in. You can also let members of the combat unit use them on dispatch missions. Mitä? Pystyis mä mukaan vittu? Mä pystyn tiputtaa ihan minkä vaan täältä. Toi ei ollut aikaisemmin. Mulla oli kyllä noita ajoneuvoja, mutta mä en pysty tehdä.
Mfinda oil field is the property of Saner, South African Natural Resources. Saner drills oil wells wherever they can throughout that region. When the oil dries up, they abandon the facility. Then it's only a matter of time before the aging equipment starts leaking crude. That means United's takeover is the perfect cover for Saner. Now they can blame the spill on a bunch of oil thieves. However you look at it, Saner's far from squeaky clean.
Poikasen. Se on, kun tää auto hidastuu entistä enemmän tuon veden päällä. Silleen tää muutenkin on ihan helvetin hidas, niin sitten vielä hidastuu entistä enemmän. Hei, missä mun katto on? Hirveetä rallia, saatana. Kenia ralli uudestaan. Oh, saatana, se on noin lähellä. Joo, mulla ei todellakaan varaa nostaa enää takaisin. Jumalauta, mä oon lähellä.
Sound of rainfall should help to mask your footsteps. There it is. The oil facility. To stop the leak, you need to shut down the oil transfer pump and destroy the oily water separator tank. The details are on your iDroid.
Ah, niin joo. Kun Afganistanissa oli se hiekkamyrsky, täällä on vesisade ja ukkonen. Ja Afganistanissa niin noi kuulo ja näköplän hävisi täysin. Täällä ei näkö hävisi täysin. Jumalauta, se merkkaa tätä porukkaa tähän.
Analysis complete.
Jumalauta, täällä on hyvää porukkaa. Aika paskaa porukkaa.
Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Analysis complete.
Jumalauta, täällä on porukka. Ei mun kannata edes saattanut koskea kehenkään.
Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Analysis complete.
Siin kaikki. Ei tässä voinut olla kaikki. No ei, täällä on lisää porukkaa jossain. Mikä se mun tehtävä oli? Shut down the oil field facilities transfer pump and destroy the separator. Pitää tuhota paskaa. Pääseekö tästä alas? Pääsee. Pääsen noin portaan.
Unit, give me, I supreme. The PF soldiers are speaking Afrikaans, an official language of the Republic of South Africa. Boss, we're gonna need someone with the Afrikaans interpreter skill to understand what they're saying. We'll look into it here, but for now, you'll just have to make do without one.
Spit it out.
Niin mulla on jo sillan. Mähän sain Afganistanista.
Afrikaans is the lingua franca for mercs in that area. If you're going to get any information from interrogations, you'll need an interpreter.
Mulla on jo se Afrikaans. Silloin heti melkein pelin alussa. Mun mielestä. Mun mielestä mä sain sellaisen. Sitten se ei vaan hyväksy sitä, koska se on liian aikaisin. Pääseekö täällä? Voi sit kun täältä pääsee. Missä se yksi vihollinen on? Oi se lähti pois. Nice. Oh, pitut se mihkää lähti, saatana. Se on tossa.
Analysis complete.
Oh fuck. Täytyy hoitaa se pois. Voi vittu, se koira menee tuolla. Jep. Doke vaan juoksentelee tän. Pääseekö tuolta mistä? Varmaan pääsis, mutta...
Analysis complete.
En ole.
Analysis complete. Analysis complete. Analysis complete.
No jätkä vaan. Tuolla on ylhäällä yksi vahtimassa. Tää on tällä hetkellä kaksi. Mut se toinen on partiokaveri. Sitten täällä on yksi partiokaveri ja kaksi vahtimassa. Keskiö. Puolet ajasta tullut käytetty. Ei puoltu. Kyllä tuo talhaat pääsee. Mietin. Okei, siihen virtaan ei voi mennä.
Snake, talk to me. Snake.
Se vaan kuolee sit. Niinku onko tota jo. Voi vittu.
to prevent the machinery being turned back on again. You need to turn off the oil transfer pump and destroy the oily water separator tank. Check the details on your iDroid.
Saatana. Hyvä, kun ei sitäkään ollut kerrottu mitenkään, että tappaako se vai ei. Kyllä mä näen, että siinä oli niinku virtaus, mutta se ei, ensinnäkään se virtaus ei näyttänyt niin kovalta. Ja jos se olisi ollut kova virtaus, se Snake olisi vaan lähtenyt liikkeelle ja sit se olisi mennyt pois sen alueen ulkopuolelle. Lähtenyt menemään. Et se miten toi olisi pitänyt periaatteessa toteuttaa on, että se Snake lähtee liikkeelle sen virran mukana. Ja sitten sitten sulla olisi vielä jonkunlainen mahdollisuus ottaa kiinni jostain. Mutta ei, se vaan kuolee sua. Tää ei mitenkään edes hyvä kaveri.
Analysis complete.
Ei, täysin paskaa. Ui saatana. Ei todellakaan pitänyt tehdä. Pian. Kaveri jää ihan keskelle siinä. Tämä ei todellakaan hyvä asia. Mä heitän tän vaan laidan yli sinne altaas. Tuolla on jotain. Mitä tuolla? Ei täällä ole. Täällä on loistavaa. Mikä vittu toi on? Ei, se on joku vitun tukipalkki. Jota on vaan mallinnettu poistuu. Miks toi on stun? Oi vittu, se voi herätä. Okei, nyt mun ei tarvi huolehtia tuolta ylhäältä. Tuolla on yksi kaveri ainakin. Nyt nää voi heittää laidan yli. toi kaveri tulee. Tai ennen kuin... Oi vittu, se kaveri on tullut tänne. Tänne. Hyvä, ettei hypänny! Oi vittu, ei pitänyt tollain tapahtua. Tää on aika hyvä kaveri. Ei vittu. Ei vittu! Se on tää... Aamu. Aivot ei toimi aamulla. Sen takia aamulla ei pitäisi tehdä yhtään mitään. Ui, perkeleen vittu saatana. Et sä nyt vittu oot tulos tänne. Mihin sä tapoit sen jätkä? Mihin vittuu se tappo se? Ei saatana, mä sanon. Ei täällä. Täytyy olla muuten pikkasen varovainen tuon Didokin kanssa. Didin kanssa, kun se voi vittu... tappaa jonkun tonne... hevon kuusi. Mitä mun piti tehdä? Mun piti shut down oil transfer pump. Todennäköisesti se ei oo toi virta syden, mikä tuossa. Eiku. On se. Se on se virtasysteemi täällä alhaalla. Toinen on tuo. Tän Didin asian. Se on hyvä, kun toi vartija luuli oikein. Okay, tästä ei varmaan pääse. Joo, tarvii tie.
You have arrived at your destination.
What? Ah, se ei sitten ollutkaan se. Nice! Se ei edes ollut se vitun virtajuttu. Joo, se häviää toi.
Destroy that separator tank. You'll need to use explosives. Got any C4?
Joo. Mitä toi? Oliko se toinen, että shut down vaan? Joo. Toinen on vaan shut down. Joten.
All right, you planted the C4. Don't set it off until you're at a safe distance.
Kaksi niitä. Räjätän ne vasta sitten, kun mä oon hoitanut ton toisen. Se on ihan tuolla ylhäällä. Pääsen tossa.
Good. You're away from the tank. Once it goes up, the enemy will come running. Secure the area before you detonate the C4.
Vittu se nyt pörrää tuolla toi. Mistä vitusta tää lähti? Tää on just hyvä, kun tää on yöllä, niin täällä ei oo niinku yhtään ketään. Oh shit! Mitä noi kaverit tuolla teki? Nouseeks toi vesi?
Analysis complete.
Se on hyvä tau. Heippa. Onneksi muuten tulin kauemmas siitä, että mä ollut ihan sieltä. Nyt ne ei tiedä yhtään, missä mä oon ollut. Auto on tuolla. Kuinka kauas mun pitää juosta? Jumalauta, mun pitää mennä pitkään. Olis pitänyt ajaa se auto tälle puolelle. Tästä suoraan, kun ois mennyt. Se on ollut loista. Mut joo, ne... Se on hyvä, kun tuli se katsiin, niin mä olin silleen, että oh shit, ei kai se spawnaa mua takaisin sinne johonkin keskemmälle sitä. Ne facility, mutta... Ei, se on... Eli sä pystyt aika hyvin tollain säätää sitä, että mitä tapahtuu. Et jos mä olisin ollut siellä ihan keskellä, vaikka siellä ylhäällä, mä olisin räjäyttänyt samaan aikaan, kun mä laitan sen pumpin pois päältä, niin mä olisin ollut ihan täysin pusissa. Olisi tullut paljon vaikeammaksi toi homma.
Analysis complete.
Miks mä oon jo tästä? Nyt ne ei edes löydä mua sieltä enää, kun mä olin jo periaatteessa pois sieltä alueelta.
That's
it. You've made it out of the hot zone. No sign of the enemy. Mission complete, boss.
Loistava.
Extraction arrived at Mother Base. Development project has been added.
Gatling gun?
Mission complete. Great work.
B. Mutta joo, ei tullut yhtään miinusta. Ei tullut yhtään miinusta. Eli toi pitää vaan tehdä ihan vitun nopea. Siis ihan sairaan nopea.